In this illustration, we'll analyze the conduction through connecting rods. We are given that few rods of material X and Y are connected as shown in figure, and the cross-sectional area of all the rods here are same. And if an A is maintained at 80 degree and an D is maintained at 10 degree centigrade, we are required to calculate the temperatures of junction B and C in a steady state. And we are also provided that the conductivity of material X is double than that of Y. That means we are given that Kx is equals to twice of Ky. So here we can write for steady state of conduction, if temperatures of a junction B and C are TB and TC, then we use, for junction B and C, we can apply Kirchhoff's laws or the rate of flow of heat throughout the regions from A to D should remain constant. Whichever channel we opt, it won't make any difference. So here we can write for junction B, here we can write the amount of heat which is conducted from A to B. The rate can be given as 80 minus TB divided by the thermal resistance of the rod AB, which can be written as 1 by Kx multiplied by L by A. And that should be equals to the amount of heat which is going from B to C through these two paths. So that can be written as TB minus TC divided by the resistance of this rod Y, of material Y, which can be written as 1 upon KY multiplied by the length, we can write as pi L by 2, as the radius of the circle is L by 2. So this will be pi L by 2A plus the amount of heat which is conducted through material X, which we can write as TB minus TC divided by 1 by Kx multiplied by pi L by 2A. Here we are given that the value of Ky we can write as Kx by 2. So simplifying this relation, will be finally getting 80 minus TB is equals to the 3 upon pi, because here pi L by A and all values of Kx gets cancelled out. If we substitute Ky as Kx by 2, then this will be 3 by pi times TB minus TC. This is here equation 1. Similarly, we can write the equation for junction C, where the amount of heat coming from these two circular rods will be equal to the heat which is conducted from C to D. So here we can write in this situation TB minus TC divided by 1 upon KY multiplied by pi L by 2A plus TB minus TC divided by, for the amount of heat conducted through X as 1 upon KX multiplied by pi L by 2A is equals to TC minus 10 divided by this 1 upon KY multiplied by L by A. Here if you simplify this relation, it gives TC minus 10 is equals to 6 upon pi times TB minus TC. This is the second equation. If we solve these two equations, which I am leaving as an exercise for you, you can solve. For solving equations 1 and 2, here we get, we can directly write down the results. The value of TB will get is 60.52 degrees centigrade, and TC will get 19.74 degrees centigrade, which are the results of this problem.